fall Sunday, the morning air time. Our celebrants, Father Bob, our homilies, and students of radio. Our opening hymn is number 415, in your spirit songbook. Please stand and join.
Is being offered for Nancy Rooney, requested by the Bolton KFC. Also, the deceased members of the Wallace family, requested by Ray Wallace, and Mariana Romita, requested by the children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. And we begin our prayers this day in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And we ask for the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit to be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, Jesus calls us to be his witness to the world. And he says to us what he said to his first disciples, "Do not be afraid." Let us bring our fears to the Lord and ask for his help in overcoming them. Lord Jesus, you give us strength when we are weak.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you give us courage when we are afraid.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give us a new heart when we fail.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm in the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah cried out, "I hear many whispering. Terror is all around. Denounce him. Let us denounce him. All my close friends are watching for me to stumble. Perhaps he can be enticed, and we can prevail against him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me like a dread warrior. Therefore my persecutors will stumble, and they will not prevail. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, you test the righteous. You see the heart and the mind. Let me see your retribution upon them. For to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death came through sin, so death spread to all people because all have sinned. Sin was indeed in the world before the law, but sin is not reckoned when there is no law. Yet death exercised dominion from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sins were not like the transgression of Adam, who is a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if the many died through the one man's trespass, much more surely have the grace of God and the free gift in the grace of the one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for the many. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Fear no one, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear the one who can destroy both body and soul in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before humans, I also acknowledge them before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before humans, I will also deny before my Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Elderly lady named Maud had a window seat on this big 747 Alitalia jetliner that had just taken off for Rome. She had been saving for years to fulfill her dream of visiting the Eternal City. But it was her first flight and she was terrified. And even the stately presence of the four bishops seated behind her didn't help. With fear and trembling, she finally opened her eyes and peeped out the window, just in time to see one of the plane's four engines break loose from the wing and disappear into the clouds. "We're gonna die, we're gonna die," she cried out. "We're gonna die." Well, the flight attendant consulted with the pilot, who announced to the passengers that everything was under control and that they could easily fly back to Toronto and safely land with three engines. But Maud continued to cry, "We're gonna die, we're gonna die." The flight attendant went to her and said, "Don't worry, my dear, God is with us.
We have only 3 engines, but look, we have 4 bishops. To which Maud replied, I'd rather have 4 engines than 3 bishops. Across 2,000 plus years, Christianity has grown from a tiny community of disciples gathered around a village miracle worker named Jesus of Nazareth to a world religion counting over 2 billion members. Statistics predict that by mid this year, right now, the count would be 2.6 billion. In its early centuries, Christianity achieved a phenomenal growth rate. It is estimated that it had reached roughly 30 million followers by the year 350. Yet things might not have turned out that way. Scholars now believe that dozens or even hundreds of prophets and other teachers founded world religions and new movements of varying sizes in antiquity. Now, most of them flourished for a time and then they petered out, they died out, while Christianity went from strength to strength. There are varying explanations for this success. Now, I think one of the main reasons is that the believers were not afraid to die for the way, as it was known in its infancy. It has been said that Christianity is flourished on the blood of the martyrs. The death of Jesus around the year 30 AD did not mean the end of his teaching. Jesus' followers saw him as the Son of God and the Messiah, and they believed that he was resurrected from the dead. His disciples remembered Jesus appearing to them and telling them to carry his teaching to all the nations of the world. This belief led to the death of all of the original apostles, with the exception of John. We know Judas hanged himself. St. Paul, St. Stephen, St. Lawrence, and numerous others also paid with their lives for the belief in the risen Christ. Under the Emperor Diocletian, as many as 3,500 Christians were executed by imperial edicts. These people lived the message we just heard in today's gospel. Be not afraid. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Here's an example. St. John Chrysostom, he's a doctor of the church. He was the patriarch of Constantinople in the 4th century. One of the stories surrounding his faithful witness concerns an occasion when the Roman Emperor Arcadius had him arrested and charged with being a Christian. If Chrysostom did not renounce Christ, then the emperor would have this Christian leader banished from the kingdom. Chrysostom responded to the threat by saying that the emperor could not do so because the whole world is my father's kingdom. Then replied the emperor, I will take away your life. To which Chrysostom said, you cannot, for my life is hid with Christ in God. Next, threatened with the loss of his treasure, this saint replied, you cannot, for my treasure is in heaven where my heart is. The emperor made one last effort. Then I will drive you away from here and you shall have no friend left. But again, Chrysostom responded, you cannot, for I have one friend from whom you can never separate me. I defy you. For you can do me no harm. F-E-A-R spells fear. Some use it as an acronym for false expectations appearing real. Now, we have all faced it in some point in our lives. It certainly is incredibly powerful, and it can be paralyzing. There are so many fears listed scientifically, I could spend days just listing them. There's, of course, the fear of flying, as Maud had in the story, the fear of being in confined spaces, the fear of spiders, the fear of public speaking, fear of the dark, fear of heights, and so on. All fears have names, like erythrobutyrophobia, Anyone know what that is? No. No. Arachbutyrophobia. I don't think anyone knows. You believe it? The fear of peanut butter sticking to the roof of your mouth. That's a fear? It is, because I looked it up. I was looking at all this last night. And this one has to be the weirdest one. Hippopotamonstrosis quipedaliophobia. I practiced this last night so many times, I still can't get it. Hippopotamonstrosis quipedaliophobia. Any idea? Exactly what it is, the fear of long words. There really are so many fears. As I mentioned, I could go on for days. In today's gospel, Jesus tells his disciples not once, not twice, but three times, not to be afraid. Afraid of what, we might ask? Afraid of nothing, Jesus would reply. Absolutely nothing that is of this world. The only thing that we need to worry about is the one who can destroy our entire being, and that is God. When we are witnesses to the gospel, we need not be afraid of what anyone has to say or can do to us. In Psalm 118, the psalmist speaks directly about this. In verse 6, it says, "With the Lord on my side, I do not fear. What can mortals do to me?" Unfortunately, we live in an age and time where fear can and does dominate us. And if the ordinary fear of illness and death are not enough, we now live with the fear of global warming, natural disasters, looming economic crisis, war and strife, and we're still fearing the remnants of COVID. These fears often cause us to build walls of protection against the unknown, but they can also prevent us from being good Christians and living our lives to the fullest. For when we fail to speak up for justice and equality for all people living on this planet, we are certainly hindered by fear. In today's gospel, Jesus is telling us to speak out, to proclaim from the rooftops what he himself whispered. And what Jesus whispered to his disciples long ago, he whispers to us today. Go out and proclaim the good news of salvation to all people. This is what we're invited three times. This is why we're invited in the gospel three times, not to be afraid. We are called to be brave daughters and sons of God. But how many times has fear kept us from being brave? I speak from experience when I say that it certainly has played a part in my life. How many times have I heard the name of the Lord spoken in vain and said nothing? How many times have I been party to gossip or speaking ill of others? Why am I not brave enough to speak out? Fear. Afraid of the retaliation that will surely come my way. Afraid of getting into an argument with the offending person. Afraid of letting the other person know what my beliefs are. I know I should speak out. And afterward, I'm even angry with myself and resolve not to let these opportunities pass by again. For you see, it's very easy to speak about Jesus to someone who is willing to listen, like all of you are here today, I hope. This becomes very difficult when the other person turns a deaf ear or outright denies the existence of God. So what I just shared with you from my own experiences, some of you can probably relate to. We are asked to speak Jesus's message with courage and conviction. We need not be afraid of what others might say or do when we speak out in favor of the marginalized and the powerless, the poor and the homeless, the addict and the imprisoned. For as the psalmist says, what can mortals do against me? And as we do so, we are assured that God will remember us. Even the hairs on our heads shall be counted. It's incredible that these words spoken over 2,000 years ago speak to us today. And we're assured that God is with us. God is in us always. So be not afraid to speak God's truth. Amen.
Let's profess our faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We now bring our petitions before the Lord. Just as Jeremiah committed his cause to the Lord, let us commit our needs, our concerns, to the Father who knows every detail of our lives and who loves us sincerely.
For the leaders of governments, that God may guide their minds and hearts so that people everywhere may enjoy religious freedom, security, peace, and health, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this faith community, that our lives may bear witness to the faith we profess with our lips, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are suffering because of their faith, or because of their stand for truth and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today, that Christ may deliver us from fear and cowardice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our sick relatives and friends, we pray for those names listed in our bulletin sick list, especially Kathy Coupland, who is Judy Adler. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our loved ones who have died, those who died this past week, and especially all those who rest in our cemeteries, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own special needs and all those who have asked us to pray for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world, especially in the Ukraine and all places of strife, through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, the Queen of Peace, we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. God of power and love, grant us in all our tasks your help, in all our doubts, your guidance, in all our weaknesses, your strength, in all our sorrows, your consolation, and in all our dangers, your protection. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
pray, my sisters and brothers, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its actions, we may make offerings of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, with the hosts of powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as, without end, we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the Francis our Bishop, sorry, and all the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for his own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of our Lord's love and peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Thank you. Just a couple of brief announcements. Just a reminder that the weekday masses are back here at St. John's. So they'll be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday at 8:30 a.m. And I'd like to thank Margaret from Rock Garden Farms who donated the flowers for our cemetery monument. Also, I have to say that I'd like to congratulate Deacon Silverio because he's celebrating his 13th year anniversary as a deacon. So it'll take him a long time to catch up with me, but 13 years is a long time. And just a reminder, baptism prep is on July 5th at 7:30. I want to thank the Knights of Columbus in a very special way. You may have noticed the sign is in its process of getting replaced. We've been talking about doing it for a number of years, and it kind of slowly got to the point where we really had to do something about it. So, of course, Ed's here. Ed's on the Finance Committee. Ed Rooney helped with getting the sign together, and Paul and all the Knights, so I'm very grateful for that. We're slowly but surely, hopefully by the end of July, we'll have it done. We're trying to kind of, first of all, get all the graphics worked out and everything else, and then kind of get it looked after. So it takes some time. But you can check it out on the way by. It needed a little bit of help. I don't know if you can, most people can tell it needed a little bit of help. So we're going to give it a little bit of help. So I'd like to thank you all for being here. It was a good thing that it didn't rain when we were coming in, because it came down pretty good, didn't it? So one thing about a metal roof, you can kind of hear it when it gets there. So, have a wonderful evening and have a blessed, glorious week. I usually tell a little joke, so kind of fits in, because sometimes we don't often speak about God, as Deacon Silverio said. There's a little girl, and she brought her girlfriend over for Sunday dinner. And the mother said, "Oh, do you like Brussels sprouts?" And she says, "Yes, I like Brussels sprouts." So then she had, of course, Brussels sprouts out in the plates and everything. And at the end, when she was clearing the table, there was Brussels sprouts on her plate. And she said, "Well, I thought you said you like Brussels sprouts." She says, "Yes, I do like them, but not enough to eat them." I guess that could be true of all the Christian principles. We love them, but we need to share them. So go out into the world and share them. Have a blessed, glorious, and wonderful week.
Let us sing and pray.
Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. And thank God for air conditioning, by
the way.
And for Patricia stepping in for Sylvia. Thank you, Patricia.
Our closing hymn is 185.